Hello, in this video, we're gonna be discussing the cerebrospinal fluid, what it is, what it does, and how it relates to breathwork. An understanding you need so you know what you're doing while deep conscious breathing, and so you're not just following instructions just for the sake of it. Let's start off with what is cerebrospinal fluid. Cerebrospinal fluid is a fluid which has three primary functions. One is supplying oxygen and nutrients to the brain and the spinal cord, which holds the nervous system. Two is lubricating the brain and the spinal joints, allowing freedom of movement for the spine. Three is removal of waste within our bodies. Cerebrospinal fluid gets created in the brain, travels down the spine, and then travels back up to the brain.
CSF
is not like the heart. We don't have direct veins supplying oxygen to the muscles and then different veins bringing carbon dioxide back to the heart. Cerebrospinal fluid has the ability to flow simultaneously up and down the spine. Doesn't flow unidirectional. It's a rhythmic wave of flows, inhaling and exhaling, creating pressure which pushes and pulls the cerebrospinal fluid up and down from the brain down to the spine, from the base of the spine up to the brain. What you need to understand is the balancing of negative and positive pressure. When we create more volume in our lungs with a diaphragm contraction, which expands the rib cage, this creates more volume and it creates negative pressure inside your torso. This pressure needs to be equalized with the positive pressure of the atmosphere. And that is why when you take a deep inhale, which expands the rib cage, the oxygen gets sucked into you because the pressure is being equalized.
CSF
is impacted by breathing. When we inhale, we lower down the pressure, creating more volume in our lungs. This allows the cerebrospinal fluid to go from the brain down to the spine. And when we do deep conscious exhalation, we create pressure by contracting the abdominal and diaphragm muscles, which reduce the volume in our lungs, forcing the air out with pressure, which allows for the cerebrospinal fluid to flow from the bottom of our spine back up to the brain. With that being said, there are three main ways of affecting the pressure within our body. One is through deep conscious inhalation and exhalation. One is through holding the breath either after inhalation or after exhalation, or tensing your abdominal and pelvic floor muscles, which engage the pelvic diaphragm and your abdominal muscles in creating extra pressure in our bodies. With that being said, I would like to point out the similarity between ancient yogic knowledge and the cerebrospinal fluid flow. The ancient yogic tradition speak about pranayama pushing spinal energy up the spine. Could it be that the ancient traditions just found a way of describing physical phenomena related to cerebrospinal fluid traveling up and down the spine? Understanding and researching cerebrospinal fluid is very important for any fighter who does striking martial arts, because cerebrospinal fluid is one of the body's main defensive mechanism, which provides protection from impacts. For our brain, the fluid is like a cushion which neutralizes the force of the impact. So when we are fighters, we want to make sure we're breathing and we are hydrating ourselves properly in order to make our cerebrospinal fluid production and circulation as efficient as possible. Obviously, this is a complicated topic which I could spend a lot of time talking about. There are different ways to improve cerebrospinal fluid flow. However, just for the sake of this video, I want you to be focusing only on the breathing aspect of it and on the positive impact it has on lubrication of the spine and joints and the brain, improving nutrients and oxygen supply to the brain and to the nervous system, and removing the waste from the brain and from around the spine created by our metabolism. And this is why I'm making this video now, because I want you to understand what is actually going on inside your body when you're doing deep inhales, when you're doing holding the breath, when you're doing deep exhales. Understanding of what's going on inside you when you actually do breath work, because I want to get on to stuff like holding the breath, and I just don't want to tell you hold the breath for the sake of it. I want you to understand what is going on.